Hello guys, how are you doing? My name is McKenna. Welcome or welcome back to this YouTube channel. For those who are new here, kindly subscribe, like, comment and share. And for those who have been here, those who have been supporting me, the returning subscribers, guys, thank you so much and a lot of love from me to you guys. May God bless you. So if you haven't subscribed, hit that notification bell and guys, get to join McKenna's family. First of all, I'm so thankful to God because it's already December and I'm grateful for the gift of life and don't take it for granted, guys. Now, today, guys, I want to talk about few things that I've learned in 2024, guys. And because we are almost leaving this year, we are almost getting to 2025 by God's grace. So these are the things that I've learned that you have to leave them behind. These are burdens that you have to leave them behind. These are struggles. These are the things that we have to leave them behind so that we can get moving. These are some of the habits that you should or you must leave them in 2024, guys, if you want things to work on the year 2025 by God's grace. So guys, the first thing I've learned is you should stop pleasing people, because people pleasers, they often struggle to set and enforce boundaries, which leads them to people taking advantage of them. Because when people learn that you like pleasing people, like, you can't make everyone happy. And let me tell you guys, whenever you have maybe 100 people, you will try to make all of them happy, these 100 people. But the fact is, 10% of them, they will not be happy about you. So stop being a people pleaser. Live your life. Do what makes you happy. Stop making people happy. Stop being a people pleaser. Usifurahishe watu sana ujisahau. That's what I mean. Number two is living above your means. Mommy, my dear, don't live above your means. Live within your means. Do what you can and leave what you can't behind. Like, for example, in maybe in this era, in these decades, you can see a lot of people are trying to live a lifestyle that is not within their means. Mtu anaenda anaingia kwa nyumba ya 20,000 na salary yako yenyewe ni 40,000. Okay, you want a good lifestyle, but is that house within your means? Are you affording it? Am you trying to rely on other external sources like loans so that you can make people happy? No. Live within your means. Kama ni kitu ya 10 bob donaeza ku afford, don't kill yourself to get that thing of 20,000, my dear. Live within your means. That is number two. Number three, stop seeking unnecessary validation from other people. Like, oh my God. You know, nowadays, because of an unnecessary validation or opinions from other people, you get to understand that a lot of people, they are getting emotional instability because they feel like they are not in, they are not worthy, they are not enough. Like, you want other people's opinions to run your life. You want people's opinions to be your drive. No, jipende. Wacha kutaka more validations from other people. Work on your self-confidence. Work on your self-worth. Like, try to love yourself, mama. Hata kama wakupendi. Si jipende. Jipende. Be confident enough. Okay? That is number three. And number four is procrastination. Let me tell you guys, like, for me, literally myself, hey, 2024, I've been procrastinating things. Like, oh my God, I'm trying to do this, or I'm planning to do this thing in the next hour, tomorrow, and I don't get to do them. I don't know why, but sometimes one of the things, like one of the things that I will try and leave behind in 2024 is procrastination, my dear. Try to manage your time. Try to break down your task into smaller steps. Like, do what is possible. Set your goals right. Manage time effectively. Wacha kuwa like, hey, unajua tunakuanga like, nitafanya hii kitu jioni. Jioni ikifika unasema, nitafanya kesho. Kesho ikifika, nitafanya kesho kutwa. And that's how we end up being losers. That's how we end up being failures. So another thing is anxiety. I know anxiety is one of the things that has been the dream killers. One of the things that usually kill our dreams and our goals is anxiety. I don't know. We are fearing, like we are fearing so much. And one of the things is fear of unknown. Like you want to try something, but you're like, what will happen? How will I start it? Start it. Do it. Try it. What the worst that can ever happen? If there's someone that you have to face for your life to be better or for them to connect you to your destiny, or maybe they can be bridging your destiny, face them. Talk to them. My dear, what the worst that can happen? The only worst that can happen is when they say no. But let me tell you, failure is just a drive to success. You know, failure is just a stepping stone. Why are you fearing the things that you don't know? Stop this fear of unknown. Sometimes I know we are normal human beings and it is nature to fear things that we don't know what will happen. But try as much as you can to do better. Another thing is overcommitting. Overcommitting yourself is good because we're in a society whereby they expect us to be busy. They expect us to do more. They expect us to be productive. But in this point of committing, you can overcommit yourself to things that does not even help your life. You can overcommit yourself to people that are not even ready to be in your life. Sometimes we do extra to wrong people. Sometimes we do extra in wrong timing. So don't overcommit yourself. Do what you can. Don't overcommit yourself. Do things that are within your capability. Another thing is parasitic friendships and relationships. Parasitic relationships and friendships, these are the things that are killing our dream, our energy, each and every day. Because sometimes, if you are in a relationship, maybe you have a lot of friends, or you are in a relationship or friendship zone, stop pouring into people's cups, those who are not ready to pour back. What do I mean? I don't mean that you're not supposed to help. You can have a needy friend. You can have a friend that is in need of your help. Help them and expect nothing back. But if you are in that parasitic friendship zone, these people, like, they want to consume all of your energy. All what they want is to receive, my dear. But they don't want to give back. They want to be helped. They want you to be there for them, but they will never be there for you. Like, these are parasitic kind of relationships, whereby it is a one-sided relationship. They benefit from you. You take your time and help them. You use a lot of energy to be part of their journey or their life, but they have never, and they will never be. But if there's that one friend who is needy, within your friend zone, do it, guys. Do it. Help who is in need. But don't be in a parasitic kind of relationship whereby it is just one-sided. Yani kazi yako ni kusaidia tu, kusaidia tu, kusaidia tu. Utachoka, utakuwa frustrated, utakuwa disappointed, my dear. Another thing is toxic relationships, toxic situationships. You know, for us, like girls or ladies nowadays, we are getting ourselves to relationships whereby, you see, most of the people, they have normalized cheating in relationships, cheating in marriages. Like, they're like, cheating is normal. Men are polygamous. Okay. Did you get into that relationship knowing that your man is polygamous? Ama, you've known it when you are already in there. For me, let me tell you guys, I will never ever normalize cheating, because a cheating will end up to disappointment, to embarrassment, to depression, to stress. If you feel like in that zone, uko, iyo ya marriage, or do you feel like that relationship or that marriage, is it worth your time? Is it worth your time? Is it worth your energy? Is it worth your life? If something is not worth you, is not worth your time, is not worth your life, just leave it. Don't kill yourself. Don't be there. Unasikia watu wamecommit suicide. Unasikia wengine wamerushana juu ya gorofa. Unasikia wengine wamefanyana sijui nini nini. If it is not working, leave it. Don't kill yourself. Another thing is regret. Don't live to regret, mama. Don't live to regret, daddy. Don't live to regret. Like, why would you live in a world of regret each and every day? If something happened in 2020, live it in 2020. You have a life today to live. You have a life tomorrow. You have children that are looking up to you. You have others that need you. My dear, why are you living in a regretive life? If ulitendwa, hiliisha, wachana mambo, hey, alifanya. No, it happened. Even me, guys, I'm learning to leave those things behind. And when you will leave those regrets back, even the grudges that you have with other people, zitaisha too, because sasa grudges in zanini. Grudges in zanini. Life have to continue. Utabeba yo mizigo mpaka lini. Stop holding on grudges. When it is done, it is done. Just kneel down, pray, and move on. Comparing yourself with others. This is the worst monster. Hey! The worst monster in life. Comparing yourself to others. Like, for example, we ladies, most of ladies, we like comparing us with others. Like, jana nimeona karo ako na wigi ya 30k and I want it. My dear, I know looking up to others and getting inspired by them, it's not bad. But also, it is better to know that we have unique path in life. Kila mtu ako na unique path yake in life. That's what I'm trying to say. Her life journey is not your life journey. Even twins don't have the same journey in life. Unapatanga inafikanga mahali kila mtu anaenda side yake. Because don't compare yourself with others. What she's doing is not what you can do. People can do their things differently. And people are gifted differently. People are talented differently. People have different unique kind of lives, so we can never be the same. You know, comparing yourself with others, it leads to unhealthy relationship, maybe even with your friends, because they're like, why are we competing? So try to be better than who you were yesterday. That's what I will say. Or try to compete with time. If yesterday you were this person, try to be someone else tomorrow. So don't compete with your friend. You want to be, if she has this kiosk, you want to have kiosk. If she's selling clothes, you want to sell clothes. If she, no, try to compete with the time and try to be a better person than who you were yesterday. Last thing, guys, and not the least on this sit down today is excuses. Excuses. Don't be a too much or mouth excuse giver person. Oh my God. You know, there are people that will always be like, hey, I didn't make this because of this. I was supposed to do this, but I haven't because of. I was supposed to be somewhere, but I am not there because, my dear, these things are killing our dreams, our goals, our aims, each and every second of life. Don't give excuses. Do what you can do right now. Don't wait for tomorrow, my dear. Tomorrow never comes. That's what they said. Tomorrow never comes. Don't give too much excuses. Try as much as you can. Try your level best. Kama ulikuwa ufanye hivi, just do it. Kama ulikuwa ufanye, do it. Don't be an excuse giver. Because, si vizuri, in short, itakula maisha yako. So guys, with that, almost 10 to 12 habits that you must live in 2024. Those excuses, you must live them in 2024. Those habits, my dear. If you want to be a better person tomorrow, if you want to be a better version of yourself, if you want to move on with life without looking back or without getting stagnated anywhere, just live those habits. These are the things that you must live back in 2024. As we are getting in 2025, by God's grace, we're going to see the year and we are going to be better than who we are today. So guys, thank you so much for your time. Thank you so much for just sitting down and listening to me. Thank you so much for being part of McKenna's family, and thank you so much because I know you're going to subscribe. Imagine the best thing, guys, that you can do for me is just to subscribe, to share, leave a comment, just say what you want us to talk about in the next video. Toodles. Thank you so much, guys. May God bless you. See you on the next video.